breaking update coming in from Afghanistan, and there's a new image which has emerged from Afghanistan. Report which shows that there is the Taliban leader, supreme leader Akhundzada, has in fact been seen in Kandahar. This is of course basis reports that we are getting of this image which has been shared by a former presenter of Tolo News. Let me go across to strategic affairs expert Maruf Raza, who's joining us over the phone line on this. Maruf, this is of course an image which has been put up online by one of the former presenters of Tolo News, who's saying that Taliban leader Haibatullah Akhundzada has in fact been seen in Kandahar province, and this is his new picture. But this of course brings to the fore the fact that he's of course an elusive leader. He's not been seen in the public domain for quite some time, and now being seen at a time when Taliban is in the process of government formation in Afghanistan.
That's right. Maulana Akhundzada has been in charge of the Taliban at least from 2016 onwards, as per many reports in the international media. He took over after the shooting down of Mullah Omar sometime in 2013-14, because for a long time there was a denial from Pakistan and from the Taliban that Mullah Omar had been eliminated in a drone strike. Akhundzada is a reclusive figure like Mullah Omar. He is in charge of the religious as well as political larger decision making, but really the face of the Taliban in the terms of engagement with the international community has been Mullah Baradar and a couple of other mullahs who have been making statements from time to time. Essentially, you see, the Taliban operates like any religious entity which has people right at the top who give the fatwas and the larger religious direction to the group. So while the Taliban is most in the news for its gun-toting militants, they see themselves as a counter to the Western model of democracy, particularly in Afghanistan. This is a narrative that has come to catch the imagination of a lot of people in Pakistan as well. And they all see the victory of Taliban in Afghanistan as a victory of Islamic Jihad. Now, it is often a subdued counter to that is not put out in the public domain effectively, that whether it was against the Russians or now against the Americans, in both cases, the Taliban claiming victory and Pakistan by default also being quite happy about the victory. It is basically because the Russians and the Americans at different times in history have chosen to go back on their own when they exhausted their patience of trying to tame Afghanistan. I don't know to what extent the Taliban will have long-term success, because their last tenure in 96-2001 was an extremely unpopular one, and they achieved nothing else except by putting people behind doors and limiting any amount, any number of initiatives to have growth, education.
Right, Mr. Raza. Right, Maruf there. Thank you so much for joining us on that breaking update.